My name is Ryan Hardigan from Econ Technologies, the creators of ChronoSync and ChronoAgent. This is a two-part series on how to sync files between two Macs using ChronoSync. To view the screencast and configuring a sync document to sync between two Macs, click the link below. In this first part, I'm going to show you how to set up a file sharing connection between an iMac and a MacBook Pro, both running OS X version 10.7.3. The iMac will be considered the local ChronoSync Mac, and the MacBook Pro will be considered the remote Mac in this example. If you're using a different version of OS X, the steps may be slightly different for you. Without further ado, let's get started. The first step is to enable file sharing on the remote Mac, which in this case is the MacBook Pro. I'm going to go to System Preferences, click Sharing, and enable the file sharing checkbox. I'm going to make a note of the computer name for my MacBook Pro, as this is what I'll be looking for on the iMac. I can change this if I want by clicking the Edit button. With the sharing panel still open, I'm going to click the Options button to bring up the types of file sharing protocols and enable Share Files and Folders using AFP. With file sharing enabled on the remote MacBook Pro, I'm going to switch back to my iMac that has ChronoSync installed. Now that I'm back on the iMac, I'm going to open a new Finder window. Within this Finder window, on the left-hand side, should be a Shared section. I'm going to locate my MacBook Pro, which will be listed by the computer name given earlier in the file sharing panel of the MacBook Pro. You may need to click the disclosure triangle next to Shared to see all available devices. After selecting my MacBook Pro, I'm going to go ahead and click the Connect As button displayed in the Finder window. Here, I enter the username and password for my user account on my MacBook Pro, then I hit the Connect button. If I've successfully entered the username and password, a window should appear showing a list of folders. I'm going to double-click the folder I want to mount, which is my user home folder on the MacBook Pro. The final result is that the Finder window shows the contents of my home folder on my MacBook Pro. So what I've shown you here today is how to enable file sharing in the system preferences of my MacBook Pro, and then how to mount and access the newly shared folder from my iMac. Be sure to watch the second installment where I will create a new sync document in ChronoSync to synchronize my documents folder from my iMac to my MacBook Pro. If you have any questions about this screencast, ChronoSync, or ChronoAgent, just visit our website at econtechnologies.com and submit a question through our product support page.